Hello, I'm Kosuke. Thank you for watching this video. In this video, let's learn how to request someone to do something in Japanese. It's like, please go, please eat, please drink, like that. This is JLPT N5 level grammar. In my earlier video, we learned about verb ないでください. The ない form of verbs is used in that sentence pattern, and it means please don't do something.But in this video, we will learn how to say, please do something. And in order to learn about this, we need to learn about a new form of Japanese verbs. So let's learn about them at the same time. The new form of Japanese verbs that we will learn in this video is the te form. Actually, the conjugation of the te form is kind of complex, so I will also teach you a magic spell to remember them easily.By the way, in this video, I assume that you have already remembered all of the hiragana and katakana characters. If you haven't remembered them yet, please check my website. I made a hiragana quiz and katakana quiz web application. I will put links to them in the description area of this video. Also, on that website, you can check my video lessons and quizzes in order. So please check it if you want to learn Japanese grammar in order. I will also put the link in the description area.I hope they will help you. Okay, so let's start today's lesson. This is a classroom. They are students. And he's a teacher. They are studying Japanese. The teacher suddenly writes a difficult kanji character. If you were the student, what would you say to the teacher in Japanese? The students want to say,Please teach us how to read it. In that case, you can say, 読み方を教えてください。読み方 means how to read or how to pronounce. を is called an object marker. It means the noun right before を is the object of the verb. We have already learned about the particle を in earlier lessons. So, if you don't remember it, please review my earlier video about the particle を from the description area of this video.Anyway, the verb of this sentence is 教えます。教えます means to teach. So 読み方を教えます means to teach how to read. And the important point of this sentence is that 教えます becomes 教えてください。ください means please. When 教えます and ください are connected, 教えます is conjugated into教えて。ます becomes て。The ます form of the verb becomes て form. I'll explain about the conjugation later. For now, let's just get used to saying that. Please repeat after me. 読み方を教えてください。読み方を教えてください。Okay, good. If the students say that, the teacher will tell them how to read the kanji. This kanji is samurai. 教えます is a verb meaning to teach. And ください means please. If we want to say please teach, we say 教えてください。教えてください。てください is what we will learn today.てください means please do something. Let's check another example. This is a wine shop. A woman is selling wine. Another woman came. She wants to check this wine. So she wants to say, please show me that wine in Japanese. In Japanese, we can say, そのワインを見せてください。そのワインを見せてください。その means the or that. 見せます is to show. Since を is following そのワイン, the direct object of the verb 見せます is the wine. So, そのワインを見せます means to show the wine. And ください means please. 見せます and ください are connected and become 見せてください。 そのワインを見せてください。Please repeat after me. そのワインを見せてください。そのワインを見せてください。Okay, good. Then the clerk will show her the wine. どうぞ means here you are. 教えます means to teach. And 教えてください means please teach. ます becomes てください。見せます means to show. And 見せてください means please show. ます becomes てください。教えます and 見せます are the must form. We have already learned the must form in my earlier video, Japanese Grammar for Absolute Beginners Part 3. If you still don't know how to use the must form of Japanese verbs, please check out the video from the description area of this video. On the other hand, 教えてください。見せてください。教えて and 見せて are the te form.We haven't learned the te form yet, so this is a new form of verbs for us. The te form is probably the most complex conjugation form of Japanese verbs. However, in our daily life, we use the te form of verbs very often. The te form of verbs is used not only to request someone to do something, but also in many other contexts or situations. So let's learn how to make the te form of verbs in this video.And if you can master the te form of Japanese verbs, other conjugation forms won't be that difficult for you. They say the te form of Japanese verbs is one of the biggest obstacles for Japanese beginners. However, to help you overcome it, I have a magic spell to make conjugation easier. I will teach you the magic spell in this video, so please never give up. Before learning about conjugation, let's review the groups of Japanese verbs.In my earlier video about the nai form of verbs, we learned that there are three groups of verbs in Japanese. We will review it now. But if you want to learn more about the groups of Japanese verbs, please check out my earlier video about nai form from the description area of this video. Okay, so let's check the groups of Japanese verbs. 書きます、飲みます、待ちます。Do you remember which group these three verbs belong to?If you want to think for a while, please pause this video and please think. 書きます、飲みます、and 待ちます are 五段 verbs. 五段 verbs are sometimes called group 1. But in my videos, let me call them 五段 verbs because this name indicates the behavior of their conjugation. And 食べます、寝ます、借ります、Do you remember which group these three verbs belong to? If you want to think for a while, please pause this video and please think. 食べます、寝ます、and 借ります are 一段 verbs. 一段 verbs are sometimes called group 2, but in my videos, let me call them 一段 verbs. And there are only two irregular verbs in Japanese. They are 来ます and します。There are only two irregular verbs in Japanese, so please remember them. Every Japanese verb is categorized in one of these three groups. These three groups are grouped according to how the verb is conjugated. So when we want to know the conjugation of a Japanese verb, we need to think which group the verb is categorized in. So when you learn a new Japanese verb, maybe it's good to remember which group the verb is categorized in, as well as the meaning of the verb.Regarding irregular verbs, it's easy to remember because it only has two verbs, 来ます and します. So what we need to be concerned about is how to distinguish between 五段 verbs and 一段 verbs. Now we are seeing the must form of verbs. Actually, must form is not a good form to distinguish their groups. But let's try just in case. Please look at the red letters. Regarding the must form of 五段 verbs,The alphabet right before ますis always I. Like, 書きます、飲みます、and 待ちます。And regarding 一段 verbs, the alphabet right before ますis EOI like 食べます、寝ます、and 借ります。So if the letter right before ます is E, we can know it is categorized in 一段 verbs because only 一段 verbs have verbs whose alphabet right before ます is E.But regarding verbs whose alphabet right before ます is I, we cannot judge if they are 五段 verbs or 一段 verbs only from the ます form of them. That's why we studied about the ない form in my earlier videos. These are the tables that we used when we studied about the ない form in my earlier video. Have you already remembered them? If you still don't remember, I recommend you to take a screenshot of this screen to remember them.But the point is that we can distinguish their groups if we remember the ない form of them. As well as the ます form, the last alphabet of 一段 verbs is I or E. So the last sound of 一段 verbs is E or A. Like 教えないです。見ないです。見せないです。And so on. On the other hand, regarding 五段 verbs, please check the red letters.All red letters are hiragana characters in the R line of the hiragana chart. So the alphabet right before nai is A. Like this. If you remember the nai form of verbs, you can distinguish if they are 一段 verbs or 五段 verbs. And vice versa, it means if you remember the group of a verb, you can know the nai form of the verb from its group. If you want to know more about the ない form of Japanese verbs, please check out my earlier video about the ない form. Also, I made another video to practice the ない form of Japanese verbs by learning ないでください. I put the links of both videos in the description area of this video. So if you want to know more, please check them. Anyway, we have reviewed the three groups of Japanese verbs. So now let's start to learn how to make verbs into the て form. 教えます見せます。Do you remember their group? If you want to think for a while, please pause this video and please think. They are 一段 verbs. We have already checked the て form of these two verbs. 教えます becomes 教えて and 見せます becomes 見せて。Regarding 一段 verbs, we simply need to replace ます with てin order to make them into the て form. 教えます、教えて。読み方を教えてください。見せます、見せて。そのワインを見せてください。Regarding 一段 verbs, we simply need to replace ます with て in order to make them into the て form. So let's try to change these 一段 verbs into て form.見ます means to see or to watch. Since 見ます is an 一段 verb, we simply need to replace ます with て. Please repeat after me. 見ます見て。見ます見て。Okay, good. 食べます means to eat.食べます is also an 一段 verb. So we just need to replace ます with て. Then what do you think is the て form of 食べます? The て form of 食べます is 食べて. Please repeat after me. 食べます食べて。食べます食べて。Okay, good. 開けます means to open something. 開けます is also an 一段 verb. Then what do you think is the て form of 開けます? It's easy for you now, right? The て form of 開けます is 開けて。開けて。Regarding 一段 verbs, we just need to replace ます with て in order to make them into the て form. Please repeat after me.開けます、開けて。開けます、開けて。Okay, good. Then, what about 借ります?借ります means to borrow. So, can you assume the て form of 借ります? The te form of 借ります is 借りて借りて。Please repeat after me. 借ります借りて借ります借りて。Okay, good. Then what about 起きます起きます means to wake up. So can you assume the te form of 起きます The te form of 起きます is 起きて起きて。Please repeat after me. 起きます起きて起きます起きて。Okay, good. Regarding 一段 verbs, please just remember that we need to replace ます with て in order to make them into the te form. Next, let's check irregular verbs. There are only two irregular verbs in Japanese. They are 来ます and します。来ます means to come, and します means to do.Actually, when we want to change irregular verbs into the te form, we just need to do the same thing as with the 一段 verbs. It means we just need to replace ます with て. So, 来ます becomes 来て and します becomes して. Please repeat after me. 来ます来て来ます来てしますしてしますして Okay, good. By the way, as we learned in my earlier video, 勉強します is a verb. 勉強します looks like two words, 勉強 and します, but 勉強します is actually one verb. The verb します can often create this kind of verb.If you want to know more about it, please check out my earlier video called How to Say Do in Japanese from the description area of this video. But the conjugation of 勉強します is the same as します. It means 勉強します is also an irregular verb. Then the te form of 勉強します is 勉強して. Please repeat after me. 勉強します勉強して。勉強します、勉強して。Okay, good. Regarding the te form, irregular verbs are the same as 一段 verbs. We just need to replace ます with て in order to make them into the te form. Regarding 一段 verbs and irregular verbs, we just need to replace ます with て to make them into the te form. 簡単です。簡単 means easy. 一段 verbs and irregular verbs are easy, right? So, are 五段 verbs also easy? Do you think 五段 verbs are also easy? Let's check if they are easy or not. 五段 verbs. 五段 verbs. He is the te form of 五段 verbs.テケ means テフォン。テケテケテケテケ。He's laughing. Actually, the テフォン of Japanese verbs is difficult. It's complex and hard to remember one by one. However, a girl came. She's saying something. 一里って耳みんで、聞いてぎいでしして、Maybe she's saying a magic spell. 一里って二尾民で聞いてぎいでしして。一里って二尾民で聞いてぎいでしして。一里って二尾民で聞いてぎいでしして。Okay.If you remember the magic spell, making 五段 verbs into the te form won't be difficult. 一里って二尾民で聞いてぎいでしして。 Let's check the details of the magic spell. First, let's check 一里って。言います、待ちます、帰ります。There are 五段 verbs. 言います means to say or to tell. 待ちます means to wait. 帰ります means to go home. Please check the red characters right before ます. They are い、ち and り。い、ち and り。いかん、て。一里って。The te form of 言います is 言って。The te form of 待ちます is 待って。The te form of 帰ります is 帰って。一、ち and 里 become て。一里って。Please repeat after me. 言います言って。言います、言って。待ちます、待って。待ちます、待って。帰ります、帰って。帰ります、帰って。Okay, good. Please remember the magic spell, 一里って。一、ち and 里 become て。一里って。I already told you about these three verbs. However, this spell is the general rule of the te form of 五段 verbs. So we can apply this magic spell to other verbs too.For example, 買います is also a 五段 verb. 買います means to buy or to purchase. When we want to change 買います into the te form, we need to check the character right before ます. The character right before ます is い. So this is the same pattern as the case of 言います. Just like 言います becomes 言って, 買います also becomes 買って.I mean, although I provided these three verbs as examples, we can apply the same rule of the magic spell to other 五段 verbs if the character right before ます is いちをり。So, remembering the magic spell 一里って二里見んで聞いて聞いてしして will enable you to conjugate all 五段 verbs. So, let's continue to learn the magic spell. Next, let's checkにびみんで、死にます、呼びます、飲みます。They are also 五段 verbs. 死にます means to die. 呼びます means to call to someone or to invite. 飲みます means to drink. Please check the red characters right before ます. They are に、び and み。に、び、and み、いかん、んで。にびみ、んで。The te form of 死にます is 死んで。The te form of 呼びます is 呼んで。The te form of 飲みます is 飲んで。にびみ、んで。Please repeat after me. 死にます、死んで。死にます、死んで。呼びます、呼んで。呼びます、呼んで。飲みます、飲んで。飲みます、飲んで。Okay, good. Please remember the magic spell にびみんで。に、び、and み become んで。いちりってにびみんで。Next, レッツチェック。聞いてぎいでしして。書きます、急ぎます、貸します。There are also Godan verbs. 書きます means to write. 書きます。The character right before must is き。き becomes いて。So 書きます becomes 書いて。書きます、書いて。Please repeat after me. 書きます、書いて。書きます、書いて。Okay, good. 木 becomes いて。木いて。Please remember the magic spell. 聞いて。Next. 急ぎます means to hurry. 急ぎます。The character right before ます is ぎ。Following the magic spell ぎで、ぎ becomes いで。So, 急ぎます becomes 急いで。急ぎます、急いで。Please repeat after me. 急ぎます、急いで。急ぎます、急いで。Okay, good. ぎ becomes いで。ぎいで。Please remember the magic spell ぎいで。Next. 貸します means to lend. 貸します。The character right before must is し。Following the magic spell しして。し becomes して。So 貸します becomes 貸して。貸します貸して。Please repeat after me. 貸します貸して。貸します貸して。Okay, good. し becomes して。しして。Please remember the magic spell しして。聞いてぎいでしして。Okay. Now, do you remember how to use the magic spell? The te form is the most difficult form of Japanese verbs. But if you remember this magic spell, it won't be that difficult. So if you remember this, it means you have overcome Japanese verbs. So let's say the spell together. Please repeat after me. 一里って二里民で聞いてぎいでしして一里って二里民で聞いてぎいでしして Okay, good. Please say this every day until you remember this. If you remember this, then conjugating Japanese verbs is not that difficult. Now, the te form of Godan verbs appeared again. What will you say to the te form of Godan verbs? Do you remember the spell now? So now, let's say it together for you to remember it. 一里って二里民で聞いてぎいでしして一里って二里民で聞いてぎいでしして一里って二里民で聞いてぎいでしして Now I'm brainwashing you. 一里って二里民で聞いてぎいでしして一里って二里民で聞いてぎいでしして Okay, good.By saying the spell 一里って二里民で聞いてぎいでしして the te form of Godan verbs becomes easy. Regarding 一段 verbs and irregular verbs, you can simply change ます to te to make the verbs into the te form. It's easy. Regarding 五段 verbs, please remember the magic spell 一里って二里民で聞いてぎいでしして I recommend you to take a screenshot of this screen and please say this spell every day. It will help you to remember the magic spell. So now, let's practice the te form of verbs. 教えます means to teach. The te form of 教えます is 教えてください。In order to know their te form, we need to know their group. Do you remember the group of 教えます? If you still don't remember the group of 教えます, maybe you should think about the ni form of 教えます。Do you remember the ni form of 教えます? If you want to think for a while, please pause this video and please think. The ni form of 教えます is 教えない教えないです。If you still don't remember the groups of the verbs, please take a screenshot of these tables and please remember them by saying the ni form of them every day. I'm sorry, there are many things for you to remember.But the ni form of 教えます is 教えない教えないです。So the sound right before ni is a sound 教えないです。It means 教えます is an 一段 verb. If the sound right before ni is e or a, it means it is an 一段 verb. So 教えます is an 一段 verb.So, in order to make it into the te form, we just need to change mas into te. Making an 一段 verb into the te form is easy. We just need to change mas into te. And ください means please. So, if you want to say please teach, you can say 教えてください。教えてください。Please repeat after me. 教えます、教えて。教えます、教えて。教えてください。教えてください。Okay, good. Next, let's think about 食べます。食べます means to eat. Do you remember which group 食べます is categorized in?Do you remember the group of 食べます? So, 食べます is an 一段 verb. The ni form of 食べます is 食べない。食べないです。So, the sound right before ない is a 食べないです。If the sound right before ない is e or a, it means it is an 一段 verb. So, 食べます is an 一段 verb. So, how do you say please eat?If you want to think for a while, please pause this video and please think. How do you say please eat? So, I will tell you the answer. If you want to say please eat, you can say 食べてください。Since 食べます is an 一段 verb, we just need to change ます into て。And ください means please. 食べてください。So, if you want someone to eat something, please tell them,食べてください。Please repeat after me. 食べます、食べて。食べます、食べて。食べてください。食べてください。Okay, good. Next, let's think about 来ます。来ます means to come. Do you remember which group 来ます is categorized in? Do you remember the group of 来ます? If you want to think for a while, please pause this video and please think. So, 来ます is an irregular verb. So, how do you say please come?If you want to think for a while, please pause this video and please think. So, I will tell you the answer. If you want to say please come, you can say 来てください。来てください。There are two irregular verbs in Japanese. They are 来ます and します。Their conjugation is usually irregular. But fortunately, regarding the te form, they are the same as 一段 verbs.So we just need to change mas into te. And ください follows it to say please. 来てください。Please repeat after me. 来ます、来て。来ます、来て。来てください。来てください。Okay, good. Next, let's think about 言います。言います means to say or to tell. Do you remember the I form of 言います? If you want to think for a while, please pause this video and if you think. Do you remember the I form of 言います? The I form of 言います is 言わない。言わないです。So the sound right before ない is a sound. 言わないです。It means 言います is a 語段 verb. If the sound right before ない is a sound, like 言わない, it means it is a 語段 verb. So 言います is a 語段 verb. The te form of 語段 verbs is difficult, right?What should we say to the te form of 語段 verbs? Do you remember the magic spell? If you remember, please say it. Did you say it? The magic spell is 一里って二里民で聞いてぎでしして一里って二里民で聞いてぎでしして If you can say this magic spell, the te form of 語段 verb is easy. Regarding 言います, the character right before ます is い. Do you remember how to conjugate the letter い? Let's say the magic spell again. 一里って二里民で聞いてぎでしして一里って一里って means 一 and 里いかん、て。一里って。So, い becomes て。So, what does 言います become? 言います becomes 言って。い right before ます becomes て。So, 言います becomes 言って。言ってください。Please repeat after me. 言います言って。言います、言って。言ってください。言ってください。Okay, good. Next, let's think about 飲みます。飲みます means to drink. Do you remember the noun form of 飲みます?If you want to think for a while, please pause this video and please think. The noun form of 飲みます is 飲まない。飲まないです。So, which group is 飲みます categorized in? If you want to think for a while, please pause this video and please think. 飲まないです。The sound right before ない is a sound. 飲まないです。It means 飲みます is a 語段 verb.If the sound right before ない is a sound, like 飲まない, it means it is a 語段 verb. So 飲みます is a 語段 verb. The te form of 語段 verbs is difficult, but if you can say the magic spell, it's easy. Now, do you remember the magic spell? Let's say it together. 一里って二里民で聞いてぎでしして一里Regarding 飲みます, the character right before ます is み. 飲みます. Do you remember how to conjugate the letter み? Let's say the magic spell again. 一里って二里民で聞いてぎでしして. 一里って二里民で二里民で means 二 be
and mi become nde. ni bi mi nde. So mi becomes nde. So what does nomimasu become? Nomimasu becomes nonde. Mi right before masu becomes nde. So nomimasu becomes nonde. And kudasai follows it. Nonde kudasai. It means please drink. Nonde kudasai. Please repeat after me. Nomimasu nonde. Nomimasu nonde. Nonde kudasai. Nonde kudasai. Okay, good. Next, let's think about mimasu. Mimasu means to see, to watch, or to look. Do you remember the nai form of mimasu? If you want to think for a while, please pause this video and free think. The nai form of mimasu is minai. Minai desu. So, which group is mimasu categorized in? If you want to think for a while, please pause this video and free think. The sound right before nai is e sound. Minai desu. It means mimasu is an ichidan verb. If the sound right before nai is e or a, it means it is an ichidan verb. So, mimasu is an ichidan verb. So, how do you say please look? If you want to think for a while, please pause this video and free think. So, I will tell you the answer. If you want to say please look, you can say 見てください. Since 見ます is an 一段 verb, we just need to change ます into て. And ください means please. So, if we want to say please look, we need to add ください after that. 見てください. So, if you want someone to look at something, please tell them 見てください. Please repeat after me. 見ます見て見ます見て見てください見てください Okay, good. Next, let's think about 書きます書きます means to write. Do you remember the nai form of 書きます? If you want to think for a while, please pause this video and free think. The nai form of 書きます is 書かない書かないです。So the sound right before nai is the a sound. 書かないです。It means 書きます is a 五段 verb. If the sound right before nai is the a sound,It means it is a godan verb. So, 書きます is a godan verb. The te form of godan verbs is difficult, but if you can say the magic spell, it's easy. Now, do you remember the magic spell? Let's say it together. 一里って二里民で聞いてぎでしして一里って二里民で聞いてぎでしして Okay.Regarding 書きます, the character right before ます is き. Do you remember how to conjugate the letter き? 一里って二里民で聞いてぎでしして一里って二里民で聞いて聞いて means き becomes いて聞いて So what does 書きます become? 書きます becomes?書いて。き right before must becomes いて、聞いて。So, 書きます becomes 書いて。書いてください。It means please write. Please repeat after me. 書きます書いて。書きます書いて。書いてください。 書いてください。Okay, good. Next, let's think about 読みます。読みます means to read. Do you remember the nigh form of 読みます? If you want to think forward, please pause this video and please think. The nigh form of 読みます is 読まない。読まないです。So the sound right before nigh is a sound. 読まないです。It means 読みます is a 五段 verb.If the sound right before nai is the a sound, like 読まない, it means it is a 五段 verb. So 読みます is a 五段 verb. The te form of 五段 verbs is difficult, but if you can say this magic spell, it's easy. The magic spell is 一里手に微民で聞いて義で死して Regarding 読みます, the character right before mas is mi.読みます。Do you remember how to conjugate the letter mi? Let's say the magic spell. 一里手に微民で聞いて義で死して。一里手に微民で。に微民で means に、び and mi become んで。に微民で。So mi becomes んで。So what does 読みます become?読みます becomes 読んで。Me right before mas becomes んで。So 読みます becomes 読んで。読んでください。It means please read. Please repeat after me. 読みます読んで。読みます読んで。読んでください。読んでください。Okay, good. So now, let's think about 行きます。行きます means to go. Do you remember the nigh form of 行きます? If you want to think for a while, please pause this video and please think. The nigh form of 行きます is...行かない、行かないです。So the sound right before ない is the a sound. 行かないです。It means 行きます is a 五段 verb. If the sound right before ない is the a sound, 行かない, it means it is a 五段 verb. So 行きます is a 五段 verb. It means we should say the magic spell, right? 一里手に微民で聞いて義で死して一里手に微民で聞いて聞いて If we follow the rule of the magic spell 聞 becomes いて聞いて So if we conjugate it following that it seems like it would become いて So does 行きます become いてください?And sorry, 行きます is the only one exception of the magic spell. 行きます becomes 行って、行ってください。Only 行きます is different. 行きます is the only exception of the magic spell. So please remember that 行きます becomes 行って。Please repeat after me. 行きます行って。行きます行って行ってください行ってください Okay, good. Regarding 一段 verbs and irregular verbs, you can simply change mas to te to make the verbs into the te form.Regarding 五段 verbs, please remember the magic spell. 一里手に微民で聞いて義で死して。But 行きます is the only exception. 行きます becomes 行って。This is how to make Japanese verbs into the te form. I hope you remember them. So now let's practice making the te form and using てください。This is the situation that we have already checked.
When the teacher writes a difficult kanji character, what would you say? Do you remember how to say, please teach us how to read? If you want to think for a while, please pause this video and rethink. To give you a hint, how to read is 読み方 in Japanese. So how do you say, please teach us how to read? So the answer is
読み方を教えてください。読み方を教えてください。
教えます is an 一段 verb and you just need to replace ます with て in order to make it into the te form. And ください means please. So you can say 読み方を教えてください。Then the teacher would tell you how to read the kanji character. Now you go to a wine shop. When you want her to show you this wine, what would you say to her?How do you say, please show me that wine? If you want to think for a while, please pause this video and please think. To give you a hint, that wine is そのワイン in Japanese. So how do you say, please show me that wine? So the answer is,
そのワインを見せてください。そのワインを見せてください。
見せます is an 一段 verb.And you just need to replace ます with て in order to make it into the て form. And ください means please. So you can say そのワインを見せてください。Then the clerk would show you the wine. どうぞ means here you are. Now someone is working. A woman comes to her. She brought a cup of coffee. She gives her the coffee saying please drink.Do you remember how to say please drink in Japanese? If you want to think for a while, please pause this video and please think. How do you say please drink in Japanese? So the answer is
飲んでください。飲んでください。
飲みます means to drink. 飲みます is a 五段 verb. So we need to follow the magic spell 一リッで、にびみんで、きいてぎで、しして。Regarding 飲みます、the letter right before ます is み。So we need to follow the magic spell にびみんで。にびみんで means に、び and み become んで。So the te form of 飲みます is 飲んで。Then when you want to say please drink, you can say 飲んでください。Please repeat after me.
飲んでください。飲んでください。
Okay, good. Now she brought a cake instead of coffee. She says, please eat. Do you remember how to say please eat? If you want to think for a while, please pause this video and please think. How do you say please eat?So the answer is
食べてください。
食べてください。食べます means to eat. 食べます is an 一段 verb. So we just need to change ます into て. So we can say 食べてください。食べてください。Please repeat after me.
食べてください。食べてください。
Okay, good. Now, she brought books. So, what do you think she would say this time? Does she say, 本を食べてください? What do you think she would say this time? If you want to think for a while, please pause this video and please think. Maybe she would say,
読んでください。
読んでください。
読みます means to read.
Since 読みます is a 五段 verb, we need to follow the magic spell. 一リッテにびみんで、聞いてぎいれしして。Regarding 読みます, the letter right before ます is み。
読みます。
So we need to follow the magic spell にびみんで。Then み becomes んで。So 読みます becomes 読んで。読んでください。Please repeat after me.
読んでください。 読んでください。Okay, good. This is what we learned in this video. Regarding 一段 verbs and irregular verbs, you can simply change must to te to make the verbs into the te form. Regarding 五段 verbs, please remember the magic spell. 一りって二びみんで聞いてぎいでしして。But 行きます is the only exception. 行きます becomes 行って。Do you remember them?Maybe the most difficult part is remembering the magic spell. 一りって二びみんで聞いてぎいでしして。So, I recommend you to take a screenshot of this screen and say this spell every day. Like, whenever you go to the restroom, please try to say this until you remember it. It will help you to remember. Perhaps your mother would come to the restroom and say, Are you okay? Are you talking alone in the restroom? But,Please never mind, mastering the te form of verbs is a higher priority than worrying your mom. So now, let's say it together again. Please repeat after me.
一りって二びみんで聞いてぎいでしして。一りって二びみんで聞いてぎいでしして。
Okay, good. And after you remember this, please visit my webpage called Japanese Grammar Test to review your memory about this lesson. I put the link in the description area. I hope you will get a perfect score. So, thank you for watching this video. Bye bye.